So tell us your name.
My name is Matthew Braden.
Matthew Braden, and you've been a GOGI leader for how long?
It's been about 3 years now.
And what drew you to GOGI? What was interesting about it? Because I know you're educated. You participate in a lot of educational opportunities. What was it about GOGI that struck your interest?
I think GOGI was one of the real first self-help groups I got involved in.
Really? I thought that you'd been involved in education for a long time.
Education, yes. I mean, like personal self-help groups gets into issues concerning your own personal story outside just the academic aspect.
So you'd been on this academic track for a long time.
Oh, yes.
Yes, yeah. I know. Yes. Yeah, you're an avid reader, an avid studier. You know your academics.
Yeah.
But at some point, GOGI became an option for you?
Yes.
Okay.
Most of my time in prison has been at other facilities.
Okay.
And they don't really offer a lot as far as self-help groups.
I see.
When I came here, when I transferred to this institution, GOGI was one of the first that I came into contact with.
What was that like? From going to book studies and courses and things to GOGI, what was that like?
Well, at first for me, it wasn't a whole lot different because we didn't have an established group. And it was in my cell doing the curriculum on my own, sending in homework, reading the pamphlets. And
well, who first introduced you then to GOGI?
It was a friend of mine who had done the same thing.
I see.
He was doing the course himself in his cell and mailing in the homework. And I believe he was in contact with you at that same time.
Who was that?
Caesar.
Oh,
Zuniga.
Zuniga.
Yes.
Okay, so Caesar Zuniga was writing to GOGI, and then he said, why don't you write to GOGI and do the course?
Yes.
And then all of a sudden, we started having workshop. And
the ball started rolling, and we got the groups approved under one of the ILTAGs here.
Right.
And we started meeting in process groups.
So you've been from the very, very beginning, you've been part of GOGI. How have you seen it grow?
Oh, it's grown exponentially.
Really?
Our waiting list is astronomical now. Yeah, we can't run groups fast enough.
Wow, wow.
Yeah.
And what about the whole prison culture? You know, you don't think of prisons, at least a lot of people don't think of prisons as being positive. But from what you're telling me, a long waiting list to get in to do this program.
Yeah, absolutely.
How is the culture affected?
The culture? The culture at this prison?
Yeah.
Is by far much different than any prison I've been to. And that is due in large part, I believe, to groups like GOGI in particular.
Yeah.
Most places have maybe AA, NA, if you're lucky, a Toastmasters group, but they don't have these sort of self-help groups that help you change, help you transform, that really allow you to get to your issues.
Yeah.
And here, I don't know how much you know about prison, but it's very political.
Okay.
There are a lot of walls that are built amongst inmates and that thrives in other institutions. And here, because of groups like GOGI, those walls are broken down and communication lines are opened. Different gangs, different races, we intermix and we talk and we become friends. Whereas before in other institutions, that just doesn't happen. And there's a huge culture shift because of that.
Tell me, what was the one thing that you learned about yourself doing GOGI? What did you learn about yourself as you went through the initial process, mailing your work in, then taking the course, and then actually facilitating the course? What did you learn about yourself?
I never really took the time before GOGI to sit down and really look at deep issues. Like, I know the curriculum was a little bit different when I first went through it.
Right.
I believe Let Go was tool one.
Well, you've been around a long time.
Yeah. One of the very first homework assignments that week was to sit down and write your own eulogy. And that's pretty deep. I mean, when you think about how you want to be remembered when you die, how you want your friends, your family, your loved ones to think about you when you're gone, it's pretty heavy. And it really makes you think, what kind of legacy do I want to leave when I'm gone?
Well, let me ask you, what kind of legacy are you going to leave when you're gone?
Hopefully a great one.
Like what? What do you see in your mind's eye? What's possible for you?
I guess using the tool What If, looking at situations from a world of possibilities, no limits.
No limits.
No limits.
Like what? If you had your dream come true, what would be some of the things that you would do?
Well, I want to leave a mark. I want to change the world. I want to have an impact in people's lives. Since getting involved in GOGI and being a facilitator, I've made friends and connections with people I never would have imagined.
Really?
And there's times now when I'll go to the yard thinking I'm going to get a decent workout in. Mm-hmm. And as soon as I get out there, one of my GOGI guys will run up to me and have a question about the group that we had that week. And before you know it, 2 hours will have had passed, and the whole time we were just walking around the track talking about GOGI. And seeing the impact that I'm making on these people is fantastic. It's remarkable.
So you're actually creating this eulogy every day.
Yes.
By your actions.
It appears to be so.
Yeah, you're leaving your mark.
Yeah.
Every day. How does that feel?
It's awesome. It feels wonderful. Knowing that I could impact somebody's life in that way. It's absolutely fantastic.
Yeah, good job. What would you like the world to know about you?
About me?
Yeah.
I don't know. That's a hard question. I don't know. It's about Matt Braden.
Yeah, what does the world need to know about Matt Braden?
I guess that I am a transformed individual.
Yes.
And I'm living a life of ultimate freedom. And in addition to that, a life of service, giving back to those that I never thought I once would have touched.
And you're making your mark, that's for sure. We're happy to have you with GOGI.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much for your service.
Thank you. I'm Matt Braden, and I'm a face of GOGI. Thank you.